Welcome to the Spy Collection. Here is Anastasios, and in this episode we'll present an artifact that played a key role in the TECHINT space of Ukrainian intelligence services in the early days of the Russian invasion, back in 2022. If we go to our spy news from 2022, week 10, story number 70, we'll read: Ukraine Security Service, SBU, shared the capture of an Orion Russian military handheld GPS GLONASS navigation device along with photos of it. The restricted military device belonged to members of the Airborne 108th Guards Kuban Cossack Air Assault Regiment and, according to SBU, the captured Orion device had store routes and waypoints that enabled them to uncover the tactical plans of future military operations, which will allow to act ahead and even more effectively destroy the enemy. And here are the shared photos. The unit with its battery removed, the rear side of both of those, and a close-up to a sticker with some further information. Here's a translated version of that. That announcement took place on March 9, 2022, and included a video of the captured Russian military personnel. This video.
Фамилия и отчество.
Козлов Алексей Игоревич.
Полная дата рождения.
2.03.1988.
Должность.
Штурмовое звено.
Воинское звание.
Капитан. 43-й отдельный морской штурмовой авиационный полк.
Место дислокации воинской части.
Саки.
Что делали на территории Украины?
Выполняли разведку в садовом районе, залетели, дали зону дежурства в воздухе, дали другие координаты. Три раза запросили, командир экипажа три раза запросил, что там находится возле Николаева. Команда лететь заданные координаты, выполнять разведку радиотехнических средств.
Какие задачи ставились на время вылета? В каких районах?
В районе Черного моря, север, юг, запад, вскрытие надводной обстановки, вскрытие радиотехнических средств, занятие стоять в зоне дежурства в заданных районах, там был сантраконкод.
На протяжении какого времени вы находились в Сирии?
На протяжении 2 месяцев.
Какие задачи ставились перед вашим экипажем во время боевых действий в Сирии?
Занятие заданных районов, то есть зоны ожидания, выполнение патрулирования, стоять на крыше прикрытия суда 4-х в воздухе.
Фамилия и отчество?
Головенский Алексей Сергеевич.
Звание, должность?
Майор. Командир авиационного звена самолета Су-30СН, Крым, Новофедоровка. 43-й отдельный морской штурмовой авиационный полк.
Какие задачи часть выполняет?
Разведка, прикрытие надводных кораблей, разведка морской акватории Черного моря, противовоздушная оборона.
Какие задачи вы выполняли?
Ведение разведки, прикрытие своих войск.
С какого времени вы проходите службу в воинской части?
С 2012-го лейтенантом попал в эту часть, гвардейская Крым. Далее в 2014-м, вместе с частью был переведен город Саки.
Вы знали, что вы выполняете боевые задачи на территории любого государства?
Вчера, да, видел, что лечу за границу, что координаты дали.
До вчерашнего дня вы не залетали территориальные?
Нет.
Кто поставил задачу вчера пересечь воздушное пространство Украины?
Задачу на вылет отправил командир. В полете были получены координаты от руководителя полетов.
Фамилия и отчество командира?
Полковник Киселев Андрей Леонидович.
Что входило в задачу вчерашнюю?
Так и сказали. Занимаешь высоту 6-0, разведка. Пункт наведения сказал, следуйте на аэродром. Разносился на аэродром, почувствовали попадание ракеты в самолет. Начались отказы, самолет накренился, попала вторая ракета, мы катапультировались.
Над каким населенным пунктом был сбит?
Там были маленькие деревни. Я так понял, что мы были недалеко от Николаева.
Since that event took place, Ukrainian and Western intelligence agencies operating the region made the priority to target those devices since they could provide tactical intelligence as described by SBU. However, those units were not available to everyone in the Russian military, and Russian forces also learned from those mistakes. From the Tradecraft perspective, all military personnel are always taught that although navigation gadgets like GPS or GLONASS in this case are helpful, they can become a serious OPSEC threat. As such, personnel should ensure that no sensitive information is ever stored in them. That's the theory, apparently. In practice, those are so convenient that even the most elite units sometimes fail to follow this guidance. Here is a nice quote from Garand Thump, or Mike Jones, who managed to reach the highest level of special operations in the US Air Force as TAC-P and SEER instructor.
If you have any type of intel, so for example, I have my Garmin watch right here, a little GPS. If I have coordinates for my friendlies, any of that, that's all stuff I probably want to keep up here and not here, where if I get killed, heaven forbid, or I'm captured and they're able to get that information, that I could possibly, get my people in trouble, get them hurt, get them killed. So again, don't just think about yourself, think about all the other people that are with you.
But enough with the history and the context. Here is our artifact for this episode. This came to our collection directly from the front line, and would like to thank the person that sent it to us. As you can see, it's a little bit damaged, just like many others, but don't worry about it. It's a pretty small handheld device with no obvious branding apart from this. The 1428009, which is its model number. Those systems, codenamed Orion, are manufactured by NAVIS, or as per its full name, Design Bureau of Navigation Systems, that has its headquarters in Moscow, Russia. Here is a closer look at it. It's a sturdy device, and those side rubber pads make it very easy to hold, even with wet conditions or with thick winter gloves. It has a lanyard hole here, and it can be charged and configured using USB. Its battery is screwed in the unit, as you can see, and if we remove it, we get access to its debugging interface, as well as the memory slot of its microSD card, where the users can store maps, coordinates, configuration settings, and so on. This is also why even damaged devices like this were still useful for TECHINT activities, since by accessing the memory card, you could still extract valuable tactical intelligence. In terms of its use, the Russian Ministry of Defense signed a contract with NAVIS to manufacture those Orion navigation units and start commissioning them in 2015. Of course, they started with the more experienced and specialized units and gradually moved to the rest. Its primary operation is using GLONASS L1 band, but it's also compatible with GPS. Here are its publicly known specs, in case you want to study this further. Let's look at its internals to see what more we can deduce. Normally the battery is glued to the back of the case, but here it has detached due to the impact the device had. On the bright side, this screw is locking to avoid losing it, but on the other hand it's a flathead, which is one of the easiest types to damage. All around it we have those Torx type screws, including two with anti-tampering, here and here. Well, unfortunately we'll have to tamper those to get a better look at how NAVIS Orion works. Let's do this. And here it is. All around it we have this sealed gasket. And this is the main unit with its GLONASS antenna. Its speaker. Down here is the TWI BLE integrated transceiver module for wireless, Bluetooth and BLE, manufactured by LSR. And its US manufactured Molex antenna is here on the side. We'll also link the datasheets of those in case someone wants to study them in more detail. This is the connector to the USB, the keypad and the screen. And as you might have noticed, we disconnected all of them to be able to have a look at each other's side too. And if we remove this shield, we have this. And here we have the main processing unit. A Texas Instruments DM3730. For the sake of this video, another person from Ukraine sent us this unit, which is in a much better condition and also has the pouch that Orion was shipping with. So here we'll go through its menu options with you. Instead of trying to explain each and every page, we'll simply add some English translations to help you understand what the different options are. Apparently, we didn't go through every single submenu and setting, but hopefully that gave you an idea of how it looks. And if you stayed for that long in the video, consider subscribing, since we have many more unique spy artifacts coming up soon. And if you have items like this you'd like to send us, please drop us an email. For now, that was the NAVIS Orion navigation device. It's a lesser known spy history in Ukraine. In particular, how Ukrainian and Western intelligence services were conducting TECHINT on those units to obtain tactical intelligence on military movements, targets and key locations. In the majority of the cases, convenience and security are two very hard topics to balance. Would navigating with a device like this be easy, fast, and in general convenient? Absolutely. But at the same time, it can pose a serious security risk when not done properly. Always be aware of what physical and digital traces you leave behind, and how TECHINT experts could exploit them to their advantage, since in the world of espionage, nothing's as it seems.